Okay, so I'm going to start off with the introduction, and I just did an octave D at the bottom. I know you can't see my hand down there, but I'm just playing two octave Ds. If you want to play the ones a little bit higher up, it's up to you. It doesn't really matter, just the ones below it, just to sound a lot nicer. And what you can do is just keep your foot on the sustain pedal, and that'll just hold out throughout nicely when you do the introduction. So, starting with a D in the left hand, I split this up. You can do it. You might find that a little bit difficult if you haven't played the piano much before. So, that's it. So the right hand is doing A, G, A, A, G, A, and the left hand is doing D, F, E, D, F, E, D. So start with a D. F, E, D. So it's a little bit different with the right hand. So when you'd hit the F, you're just doing an A. So when you do the D, it's an A, G, A, and then A, G, A, F, A, E, A, D, A, G, A. So that's what you do at the start, and then it changes to a B flat and A. G, B flat, F, B flat, E, go back to the A, E, A, D, A. And then E, D, A, C. And then you hit an F. When you hit that D, you move down to an F and E. D, F, C, F, B flat, and hold it there. So it's a little bit complicated, that section. All I'm going to do is run it all through again, just that bit, so you can stop and you can pause the video. You can also slow this video down as well using the little cog at the bottom right hand corner of this screen, which is just down here, so you can slow it down. But I'm going to play it again. Okay, so it's probably easy if you do just slow this video down, because otherwise it's just going to get confusing if I stop, you know, saying the notes and everything. But again, I've done it a bit slower. So then you get to the, when he kind of does that, so that's just an A, B flat, A, G, A, or some variation. If you want to do something different, that's up to you. In the left hand, I did an A sus. So I did an A, the A sus chord is an A, a D, and an E. And then you move the D to a C sharp. So it's called a suspension because it sounds like it's suspending and then it resolves. So and that leads you into the start. So I start with an F and an A in the left hand. You'll find the left hand is pretty much the same all the way through. So I start with a left hand of F and A. And then I move to an F and a B flat. And then I move to a G and a B flat. And then a G and a C. Same thing again, F and a B flat. G and a B flat. Combination of chords. So it's just, you can see it's just running around an F and an A, an F and a B flat, a G and a B flat, and then a G and a C, the tune. gets to hold on tight. I'm going to do an F and a B flat. You can add a D in there as well. And then I move to a G, a C, and an E. So going back, so hold on tight. And then we move to the chorus. Okay, so what I do here, I do the full chords because it thickened it out. So I'm going to do an F and an A like we did originally, but I'm going to add in a D. What I'm going to do now is just change that A to a B flat, but keep the F and the D. And then I'm going to move that little finger from F to a G. And then I'm going to move to a G, C, and an E. Then we do the same thing again because it repeats. Same, regurgitating around those same chords. And then it goes back to the beginning again. So if you just want to follow that through, it pretty much does that all the way through. You get to the end and it's so dangerous. You can use the same chords that we did for the chorus. So dangerous. I want to do it again. So you can use those same chords all the way through, exactly as we did for the chorus, but obviously you're just going to change the notes of the right hand, but they're all based around the same note. So hopefully this video will give you an idea of what notes you need to use. And then when, if you want to finish it off, you can do the, you know, something like that, and finish it around like you did at the beginning. So there we go. I hope that's helped you. Don't forget, if you want to use any other notes, if you think you know, you can enhance it and use any different notes, absolutely fine, go ahead and do that. But hopefully this little tutorial has helped you be able to play Dangerous by David Guetta. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to check out my other videos like this in the playlist link underneath this video, and I'll see you in the next video.